Hey everyone, welcome back to Playgrastination Population 283. Today we're back playing some more of the Binding of Isaac Afterbirth, for you these are coming out one a day, but I'm trying to record a bunch in a row. It's been like 4 hours since that last one I recorded, but pretty much in a row, you know what I'm saying? Trying to get as much of these done in a row as possible. Let's do Judas Void today. Essentially, if you're wondering how I'm choosing these characters, XL floor to start off with. I definitely thought that said Escape. If it was an 8, it would have been closer. E9PE X8MT is going to be our seed for today. XL floor, important to know, do not take red heart damage. I'm going to do this just to get rid of these voids because they're obnoxious. Just kidding, only one spawned there. Don't take red heart damage because you got your deal with the devil right off the bat. Plus, you just don't want to take damage with Judas. That was a little close. Nah, let's not do big room. Plus, you don't want to take damages with Judas in general, just because, you know, the whole, like, 1 HP thing's, like, kind of rough. So, if you're wondering how I'm choosing these characters, essentially, I'm choosing my favorite characters to do first. The ones that I think are the best, which is why we've done Isaac, Samson, and now we're doing Judas. And then, eventually, I promise, someday, we'll get to doing Maggie, and Lazarus, and the Lost, and the Keeper, and the whole gang. Lilith, oh my god. I want to vomit just thinking about that run, and not like a happy kind of vomit. Believe me, I've got plenty of those. I'm having one right now. Oh, what the f- Okay, gonna call a little bit of BS on that split, but, you know, that was my own fault for forgetting that that champion does, in fact, split. Scared me a little bit. That rhymed. Let's not die. We're also pretty lucky that it got it during, when it wasn't technically a champion anymore, because otherwise that would have killed us. I would love a consumable, a spirit heart, a key, any of the above. Let's see what we got in here. Some money, por favor. Maybe we could make work. There we go. Yep, push that nickel out. No, push the nickel. The nickel. Yes, got the nickel. Up to 13 cents. It's nothing to sneeze in. Yeah, maybe we can make it work. I don't know. Gonna need a key, as I just mentioned a couple seconds ago. Or, like, find either item room or any HP again. Spirit hearts are great. Tinted rocks are cool. Not that we have the bombs necessary to unlock them if we could find one. We've got a nice double room here. There's a key. I could go to the shop, but you know what? I'm not gonna. We're gonna be a little more risque instead, which I think is completely different. Sometimes I used to think that risque was just a fancy way of saying risky. I'm pretty sure they're completely different words. Okay, we're gonna get sticky egg sack bombs, which at the very least gives us 5 bombs. It's the bombs we're looking for, not the bombs we're looking for, whatever Star Wars universe you may be in. Now we just have to find those wonderful things known as tinted rocks, and maybe we could get a little bit of protection. A lot of possibilities as far as where I believe secret rooms could be, and because there are so many possibilities, I'm scared to actually try any of them. I think I'm just gonna save my bombs. No tinted rocks in here that I can see, though there are 2 pills that we have nothing to lose basically by opening them up, so I figure why not, and we'll get a penny for our troubles. Puberty, okay, we already saw this one, but I heard if you get 3 of these now, there might be, I don't know if it's a transformation or a tiers upgrade or a stat upgrade or what. We get a speed up, that is a stat upgrade, and then we'll go and see what's in this right here. Okay, definitely going to want to reroll these bad boys. Toxic shock is pretty good. I think we just gotta go for it. We got Ragman here. Definitely gonna go ahead and use our Satanic Bible charge because Ragman is honestly up there with, especially if you don't have good damage, probably up there for me as maybe the hardest, if not, like one of the hardest, if not the hardest, first floor potential boss fights. But we made it through. We got an HP upgrade, which is great. Don't swallow the prize. We're still going to get a 50-50 deal with the devil chance, which is actually kind of remarkable. And we're going to be fighting Monstro here, which is no biggie. Like, unfortunately, we don't have the Satanic Bible charge ready. We could have gone back for the battery charge back there, which I think was accessible. And at the very least, it could have been accessible via bombs or something. I can't remember, but Monstro is not that big a deal. I was thinking of what other first floor, like, basement boss fights could we have, and Monstro, Larry Jr., and can you get Little Horn Basement? Maybe even Little Horn or Pin. None of those really, Larry Jr., Gurglings, like, none of them really strike me as like, ooh, I think we might lose, like, not just even lose, but like take even a hit. I don't think we had a chance of taking a hit against anything. Maybe Gurglings, but let's see if we can flip a coinage. The coinage has been flipped in the wrong direction. We're just going to go down to the next floor. Unfortunately, Missed that deal with the double chance, of course. A little unfortunate. But hopefully we cannot take red heart damage on this floor either. And we can just make it work here instead. We just basically like postponed it one floor because we now have 100% chance here. Who knows what the first floor deal with the devil could have contained? I mean, you can tell me if you want. If you like want to be one of those guys that's going to be like, hey, by the way, freaking greatest item of all time was in your deal with the devil. In case you wanted, I didn't want to know. Friend. But yeah, let's look. Let's look and see if we can't find us a nice little deal with the devil here. I'd like a spirit heart. Haven't seen a single tinted rock. Could have went to the shop on the last floor. Like, part of this is on me. But I wanted to save the key for this floor. And so we can go to item room. Can't go into our curse room just yet, but I might come back for it. Let's see. This room. Not just keep it going. We're seeing a lot of red hearts. Still looking, there's a tinted rock right there. No small rock, thank you so much. We'll pick that up right now. And now we have some spirit heart protection, which means we should be pretty good. Golden chest is interesting, but not until once you've visited. At least in my opinion, not until I visited. Ah, that's unfortunate. Thought I was going to hit the void there, but I hit him instead. Not until I hit... Wow, stand back, please. Not until I manage to find... item room. And by find, I mean not only find, but get inside, please. We have wasted our spirit heart, which is a complete waste. No reason for it to even be gone. It should still be here with us right now, singing its prayers. Let's go in here. The D-Infinity, you know what. We're going to start with the D4. Reroll me, baby. We somehow kept sticky bombs. I don't know how. And we have another run now that's not so great. We're going to have D100 next. Can't get in there, of course. Every two rooms. So when we come back with our two rooms, I'll use this. Can't say I'm a huge fan of that one. Why is the tiers down minus two? Couldn't tell you. Throw a bomb in there. Get rid of these guys. It's not a great use for a bomb, but I needed to get rid of them. Okay. After two rooms, of course, we can thankfully come back and reroll. I think I'll reroll Book of Belial as well. Although it does still kind of increase your deal with the double chance, but we have 100% chance on this one. Can't even be there, so that's a good use of a bomb, basically. We just got to beat this room without taking damage, and we can get 100%. Are we going to reroll our run and keep our 100% deal with the devil chance, which I would like to keep. I like to keep! Lost our deal with the devil chance, so that sucks. Two floors in a row, not playing well so far. We're not taking, it's like we're taking the worst damage I've ever seen, but we're taking some damage at very inopportune times. So I'm going to try something. We're at 36%. If I take this, if I use Book of Belial, it should bring us up. Just holding it adds the 12 point, but putting it down gets rid of it. Okay, reroll all this. We get Blood Rites again, funny enough. And we have yet another two roll D100, so I can come back and reroll that again. Remember, we gotta make Hush Fight, so we gotta speed it up eventually. Pick up Super Ball. Don't know what it does, but in two more rooms, we'll be able to reroll Blood Rites again and also reroll our run. We're basically just rerolling until the point where we get a run that is, like, super powerful, something that we could get through the rest of the game pretty dang quickly with. And we're gonna have this 36% deal with the Devil Chance, unfortunately, which means we're probably not gonna get it on this floor either. Please, though, I would like to sneak through. Thank you. I would like to get rid of the portal. I would like to get rid of, thank you, the portal, before we spawn a 97 Fat Bats while I'm at 4.72 damage, which isn't terrible. Thankfully, Judas starts at a little bit higher than normal damage. This is still, like, god-awful, though. Please save me. This is still, like, pretty terrible. Okay, let's get this guy taken care of, please. Let's go. Thank you. Pick up the sack, see what we got in here. Joker card would be nice, but instead we get a two of clubs. And let's go reroll. I mean, now that we've taken a hit, we might as well go into our curse room. Is my thought on the matter, so we'll go ahead and do that. And we'll also reroll Blood Rites and our run once again. Piercing Shots is great, but I don't think this is a winning run. Reroll one more time. Holy Mantle's pretty dang fantastic. Ball of Bandages, pretty dang fantastic. We still are kind of suffering from that tiers downgrade. Is Super Ball giving us the occasional rubber cement shot? It must be. Holy Mantle means we can come in here for free, get our Perthro rune. We now have a D12, so reroll some rocks. This is a pretty good run, though. I think I want to keep Swallowed Penny. This is a pretty good run, though, if I'm being 100% honest, and I might stick with it. Damage is up to 5.51, which is pretty good. God, I'm sorry, I'm throwing up everywhere. Not the craziest thing. I guess with the D100, you also reroll stats every time. So, oh, please, no, 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 you don't understand. There's a little too much coming in. I was not good at dodgeball as a child. Use this here. Back to the D100 again. I only like using the D100 and D4 when you have a bunch of items, because I feel like that's how you get the crazy awesome synergies. So part of me really wants to just hold on to it for a little bit. Hold on to me, because I'm a little unsteady. And see what we get. But also, this Holy Mantle run seems pretty good. I don't know. We'll decide. See, I lost my Holy Mantle, but we didn't take damage, which is awesome. It's still not, like, honestly, we're maybe better off before we rerolled at all. But I think we can get to a point where we will have been pretty glad that we rerolled everything. Peep fight. Pretty hard to be glad when you have a peep fight. So go ahead and throw a bomb in there. Sticky bombs are gone. Now, I don't know why they lasted one reroll, but not two. Throw another bomb in. Basically, I just want this fight done. Throw another bomb down. He's going to land there. Kate, Daddy Longlegs, thank you for helping us get the job done there. Deal with the double 36% chance isn't meant to be. Which sucks, because we're missing out on items, essentially. The more items that we could take from Deals with the Devil, the more items we could have to reroll. Curse of the Unknown. Let's see what's in here. Just kidding, we won't. And I also do not know how much HP I currently have. I've been attacked from behind. If you guys could cut that out. It's okay, it's okay. Just these little freaking triangular shooting pattern guys are a little obnoxious. Just get some shots down in there. Nice. Keep going. Let's find this item room. I'm tempted to reroll soon, but man, if I don't like this run, I'll do it. Okay, this time we got Magic Mushroom. We got a Tears upgrade. We got Bob's Brain. I've stepped on a thing because we have Stompy and I got hurt, of course. And what did that do? It didn't get rid of our Deal with the Devil chance, though. So how did we get Spirit Hearts? I don't know how we picked up Spirit Hearts. I'll be 100% honest. No idea. But we must have had some. Because we didn't lose our Deal with the Devil chance when I took a hit there. So I can't explain how that just happened, but I'll be happy that it did. Still looking for Tinted Rocks. We got the D6 now. So we can reroll a single item that we're not a huge fan of. Also have that Perthra Rune. So if we can make this Deal with the Devil happen on this floor, we could really have some good stuff happen. Okay. Tears down. Yep. Not really on my list of things to do today. But thanks for coming. Okay, item room's gonna be here. We can see if this is the area that we want to use our Perthra Rune and or our D6 charge on. Let's see what kind of item we got inside. Gonna be Rune Bag. It's a pretty good item, but I think it's a good reroll target as well. I will Perthra as well. Quarter. I'm gonna take it because it counts as an item, so it's gonna get rerolled. But even when it's rerolled, we get to keep the 25 cent benefit from it, if that makes sense. Items like that, I think, are very valuable with the D4, because you get to, like, HP upgrades especially, get rerolled as if they're actual items still, because, I mean, they are technically actual items, but you still get the benefits of maintaining them. The portals make it, I like they, like, made it so that they don't spawn infinitely. It still makes it, like, a little ridiculous. Like, let's come in here. Hopefully not a greed fight. No, we'll take the compass. We will take Nun's Habit. Again, these are all just reroll targets, things to... I want more items so that the more items that we have, the more things we can reroll. And hopefully reroll into something that is just absolutely insane. Now, I don't believe the D4 rerolls your stats, which is kind of good. If we can keep this 8.7, although that's probably just doubled from 4 point whatever from Magic Mush, if we're being honest with ourselves. I still don't know how many Spirit Hearts we have, if any, so I don't want to take any damage here other than what we've already taken. Hierophant card would be great. We get a Chariot card instead. This room is no biggie, except for I almost freaking got really scared. I think that's just a visual glitch, so just, you know, if you're freaking out a little bit there like I was for a moment, you just don't. Just trust in that the cards, the gods of cards, always have your back. Okay, Ragmega's here. If we could launch Bob's Brain into him, yes, do half his damage. That is awesome. And then I'm just going to pop Chariot card because I'm scared that we don't have... Please. There we go. We'll take the moldy bread. We will take the guaranteed Deal with the Devil. Okay, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to D4 myself right now. And we're going to have this run, which is Ludo. And then we're going to take this. And we're going to take this. Don't kill me. Did not kill me. Though I imagine we're on low HP. We're going to keep the nail and we're going to keep this. I don't even know what this is. How we have like one... I don't know what's happening, but this is what the run we're going to go with. Ludo, I think, is pretty fun. We had a cool Ludo run the other day that I ended up having to reroll. I don't know why the one giant tier stays. I don't know what that is. I don't know, honestly. I'm tempted to do this room, but we also kind of got to hurry. We also kind of got to make room. And we had plenty of HP, although we didn't have any spirit arts. Okay, our damage is 8 point... What is happening here? Seems like we're not doing, like, any ticks of damage. 16 tier stat is probably what is to blame for that. Yeah, this is very bad. What is this giant... Like, I imagine this site does a ton. Yeah, that site does pretty well. The question is why... Why is it there and why is it not moving? The tiers up helps. If I get like 17 more of those, I would be pretty dang appreciative. I don't know why we have that tier that's just standing there. But like, okay, it's doing better now. The tiers upgrade helps for sure. I'm just going to stand inside this tier because as long as they run to me. Run to me. Run on to me. I don't know why our main scythe isn't doing nearly as much as I would like it to, though. That's something we're going to have to figure out if we want this run to remain a viable option. But for now, I like the reroll. It looks cool. I just don't know what item. I'm trying to see. It must be an item that we haven't seen before. I'm trying to think. Like, we have that syringe down there, which is a slightly different color than what Roid Rage would be, or growth hormones. So it's not that. But then I'm like, what the heck is making this... I mean, like, maybe... I assume if it's a syringe, it's just a stat upgrade like all the other syringes are. But maybe it does something else, and that's what's causing the one giant tier to spawn at the beginning of our runs. I don't know. Let's go ahead and fight our boss here. We don't have a guaranteed deal with the double chance. I'm going to stand right here and hope that he decides to jump right onto my scythe. Yeah, come in here. Come in here. That's where I want you to be. So if we can get both of them going, that's a pretty nice situation. Now, if you want to stay right there... Yeah, there you go. I don't know if he's getting cut up by the second one. It looks like maybe it's a nice little double lawnmower all the way across the sky. Ah, didn't quite get him to jump where I wanted him to. But he's almost done. That's going to take him down. 33% deal with the double chance. Could we get one? We do get one. We'll take the mom's coin purse. I'll look for the... We got the yes mother transformation. I don't think any of these... The puberty. We got the adult transformation, which... Did that just decrease our luck? Because that's funny and accurate. We don't know what these pills are. They could be bad. Ooh, baby, a triple. Definitely taking both of these. They're both fantastic. We're going to lose some red hearts, of course, from the pickup, but that's fine. Double infested. We still have an item room on this floor that I do want to go visit, so I think we should do that. Our speed is very bad. It's only 1.15, so it doesn't seem like it should be super bad. Look at these hairs when I'm walking upwards. Downwards, it's fine. Upwards, look at the hair. Little ridiculous. Let's look for that item room. We've got a shop here, which I will visit, although we only have 16 cents. Might as well pop this and crack open the skulls. Get a free dry baby. Anything to do a little bit extra damage, basically, at this point, I am a fan of, because for some reason, our Death Touch Ludo isn't doing quite as much as I want it to. I'm literally scanning every inch of my Isaac knowledge in my brain, which is lacking, let's be honest, to try to figure out why that tier at the beginning is just chilling there at the beginning of each room, and I can't wrap my dang head around it. Maybe that'd be something, if you have any idea, if you could like see something that's one of our items that's very obvious why it's doing this, and you can let me know, I'd appreciate it. Camo undies, we've had this a couple runs ago. Yeah, it makes you invisible every now and again. I don't know what prompts it. I assume it's on a timer. I'll go for Guppy's head. We got our keys back, and we got some money back at the very least. And we also have money equals power, so the more money we get, the better off we are, which means I should go get that penny, but I'm not going to. If we could become Guppy, which I think we're only one-third of the way. We have a curse room. I should have visited the curse room, and I think I will go back and visit it now, even though it's going to take a lot of extra time. How long does the camo last until you're hit? Let's see when we go into the curse room if it goes away. It appears to be until you're hit. Okay, it's unfortunate I'm slow. No Guppy item, but we do essentially net one spirit heart from that transaction. And okay, then we got hit again, and now we're camoed again. I'm not totally sure how camo undies work. Can enemies not... Like, if we go into a room with enemies, will they not be able to see us? Maybe it activates once you've been hit, so you can only take technically one hit in a room, and then you go invisible, and then the enemies can't see you? I don't know. It's a good little theory there. Let's keep going. Down to the next floor. Definitely interesting. An interesting run thus far. Like I said, I want to go for Guppy. This is not Guppy. Oh, and we've been hit, but it's okay. He's going to stay up there. We're going to use this pill. Again, don't know what it does, really. The speed upgrade is fantastic. I will use the Walking on Sunshine pill to my advantage. If these guys want to just keep spawning right here at the beginning, that's a pretty good place for them to be. And then who's last guy? Oh, there's no last guy. Plus 0.05 damage you shouldn't have. Okay. The tier... Okay, these guys can still see me. All right, I tried to sneak through, but it didn't quite work. It's fine. And we're almost to our next nail charge. There is, unfortunately... I mean, it's fortunate that there is a tinted rock over there, but of course we cannot reach it. So, pretty much just the world's greatest tease. You thought the world's greatest tease was acquired by using Jergen's hair essentials for men, but in fact, it's not. Get it? It's like a hair thing people do. I don't know a lot about hair. I value my hair quite a bit, don't get me wrong. I put a lot of effort into it every morning, including the hair that's on my lower head. Let's see if we can get like a card or something. We got a black heart, so I will take that. The HP is always nice, and again, we're invisible, but enemies can see us, so I don't know what the invisibility actually does as far as benefits go. This is a fantastic item. Yeah, this is awesome. Lucky Rock is great because whenever we get our nail charge all the way up, we'll be able to step on a ton of rocks and get money from it, which will then synergize with money equals power. You hear where I'm going? And we can then get a bunch of belts, 5 cents. Like, this room's not great for it, but if we could find a room with more stuff in it, we could get a lot more money. And then we can get a crazy damage upgrade. Where did all my damage go, though? Oh, we had the nail charge on the room, duh. Like, this room would be one that's pretty good to use. And all. Those guys are just really tanky, I guess. It still seems like this one's not doing much. I need to figure out the mystery of why that back tier ain't doing jack doodly squat. But that's a mystery for another day. Let's go in our item room here. See what we got. The soul is a great item. It's going to block some shots for us, which I'm quite appreciative of. Power pill is at least good to know. I will pop this open just to see. 1 penny. I don't even value going to the shop because I think we want to keep our money. Want to keep my money. Keep my money. We got a charge ready. More money as well. With Lucky Rock and the nail, we should probably expect that we're going to make it to max HP. To max money, which equals max damage, before the end of this run. Let's go ahead and pop this here. The Tinted Rock is great. For some reason, like, that thing is just going to chill over there, which, again, I'm okay with because it's just going to do... I need to be stepping on all these rocks. We're just going to, like, leave the sides... No, Bumble, no, Bumble! Bumble, please! Bumble, I need the money. I need the money, Bumble. Although, I will say, it's also a nice little synergy. Any reason they're, like, not coming out of the holes where I'm putting my sides... although I will say it's also a nice synergy to have the Lucky Rock for Bumbo in general. See, we're not doing a ton of damage, and I don't really, can't really say I get it. No deal with the devil, and we just miss boss rush. But that's okay. We got 2 more floors to do in 10 minutes. I think we can do so. And then we gotta get the hush fight done. Is this a run that at first glance I'm looking at and saying, hey, we're destined for great things? Probably, I mean... I shouldn't, like, complain about this run at all. We're at full HP, and we don't really get damaged that much. The soul is going to be nice on the hush fight, but I'm mainly worried about how this run... Oh, no. Okay, I'm hoping if we just hide behind this, it'll just cut him up like a lawnmower. It appears to have worked. Come at me. Yeah, it appears to be working. Get him. That's how it's done. Oh, no. Should not have left the safety of my lawnmower. Come on, at the lawnmower. There you go. All right, through the room. Good. Over the river and through the room to grandmother's house we go. These big rooms can basically suck a coconut. They don't really benefit me very much because I can't use my giant tear on them. So I have to use this little guy who's not doing, like I've mentioned, as much damage as I maybe would have expected. Okay? Actually, now that he's rolling around the room, now that he's rolling around the Christmas tree, we actually will do enough damage. Okay, keep going. This run is not quick, which is why I'm a little bit nervous about making it to the hush fight in general. There we go. Almost done. Gotta be close. Come on, get it. Pop this in here. We might take some damage. We might take some damage walking into these if they shoot out some things, but I think the money's valuable. Let's go. Guy can't get through the door, I'm a dummy. Nope. Again, people that come to us at the beginning of the room with the giant lawnmower are done, basically. Anyone else has a pretty decent chance of living. Which I don't like. Hey, if you could, like, not teleport. If you could stop spawning individuals. Okay, find this boss fight. Let's get it done. Let's get our 75%, 70, what am I even saying? 67.5% deal with the devil chance. Let's get it. get a deal with the devil, make it something nuts like Brimstone. Ludo Brimstone, pretty cool. And I'd also wonder why we have two of these shots. Sisters Viss, again, if I just stand over here, maybe they'll roll into it and get cut up. Yeah, get chopped, diced. Oh, you're getting freaking... Okay, that's a weird attack that makes me just a little uncomfortable. The Mom's Eye effect, don't get me wrong, is good. They're going to do their weird little, yep, shared crossing streams Ghostbusters style. Never seen Ghostbusters, so apologize. We do get the deal with the devil. We're also going to get a damage upgrade. And in here, we're going to be not fighting Krampus. Oh, can't take half hearts, so that's moronic what I just did. But I do think we should take Book of Sin just to put us at permanent Polaroid invincibility. I'd like to play this guy. No, I don't want Book of Sin. I would like to play him for the syringe chance, which would give us spun, which would give us even more damage. I understand that. But I think I'm just going to take what I got and go, basically. I value the HP just a little bit more. And not much more. Like, it's a pretty equal trade in my eyes. In mine eyes. Okay, this was the wrong way to go, unfortunately. The more dead ends we find, the less chance we can make it to the Hush fight. But 7 minutes to get through one floor, if I can't accomplish that, then I should probably just retire. Like Chipper Jones, former Atlanta Brave. Did he retire? He probably retired. I haven't watched baseball in such a long time. I don't have cable. Hey, if you could, like, please. This guy didn't get the memo about the whole, like, I really gotta go, like, right now, please. 3 cents. I mean, every little bit of damage is important. I agree with you, but also, if it's taking a minute per room, then we're probably not gaining that much. We're probably losing more than we're gaining as far as, like, not going to be able to make it to the room we need to go. There might have been a Tears Upgrade Pill in there. I'm trying to remember what that Tears Upgrade Pill looked like. We actually do want to save our keys, sadly enough, which is why I'm now wasting keys. Pick that up. Cannot. Tammy's head could be good. It's doing some weird stuff. My reflection? I don't know. Pick this up. Get all the money in this room. Again, just make it quick. Bumbo's going to pick up a ton. Max level Bumbo, I don't mind either. 6 minutes. 6 minutes. I can't help but notice we are using a lot of time. How much money we got? 67 cents. Okay, I'm pretty content with that. Bumbo's going to drop a lot of stuff because he's just happy to be here. Keep going. We're getting, I guess it's Ibdubdi, multi-dimensional baby, that's giving us those circular tears every now and again. We just have weird things on this run in general. Curse of the Lost is really freaking annoying. It's really obnoxiousing me. Pick this up. What does it got? I'm walking on sunshine. Feels like I'm walking on sunshine. Sorry. Yarrune, definitely better. Oh, what in the world was this room? Couldn't tell you. Don't know. Don't care. Might as well try these. What do we got here? Joker card, please. Two of hearts. No. Can we, like, get rid of this poop, please? Hello. I'm looking to get rid of the poop. Hermit card. Hello, I would like my Yarrune back. Okay. Apparently, we just do things. I don't really know what's happening on my screen. 5 minutes. Still plenty of time. Unless this is a dead end, and then it's going to be a little tighter on time. But, Bumble, you can go get that coin if you want. I'll let you pick that up. But I won't let you get the second one, because you can't let them get too happy. You can't let them get too content. Otherwise, their productivity goes down. I don't know. I've never been a boss. Couldn't tell you. Watched a lot of The Office, though. The chance for Guppy makes me want to do this, and I instantly regret all decisions, but we did get a Tears upgrade, so I'm just proud of myself for actually remembering that was in fact a Tears upgrade. If we could, like, speed this up, keep going, damage upgrade, there we go, we're up to 15 damage nearly, which against a multi-segmented enemy like this Chub right here is pretty good. The thing that really sucks for us, I don't think the Hush is ever going to go into our giant scythe, which I'm still concerned and confused about why it's there, but we're just going to accept that it is. I accept that it is my own son, essentially. And we're just going to hope that the Hush, for whatever reason, wanders into it. This is a dead end. Please, next room, do not be a dead end. Please be the correct way. The hope is still alive. Hope is alive. The hope is still alive. And at this point, I would say we're running off enough hope that we can pretty much guarantee that this is probably going to end up being the right way. Really, Bumbo, though. You've damaged your own poppy. You know that's a crime punishable by death. You do not touch your poppy. Also, I'm Poppy. Hopefully this is the right way. Hopefully right at the top here we'll just see, like, boss door. I'm not seeing boss door, but this way, again, still potential. And it's not like it's going to take us 5 minutes to beat the Mom fight, so I should probably stop freaking out so much. And there's our boss door right there. So, you know what? Let's stand over here. Let's give him a nice path. Yep, come at us. Okay, never mind. Bumbo's going to start cracking you up. Excuse me, I've been hit by a fly. That is just embarrassing. Okay, let's get this going. Keep dodging. All that matters in this fight is your dodges. Not the brand of car that you drive. That's not what I'm referring to. Front to melee, how you dodge. I can't tell if the top one is doing any damage to her, but it looks like Bumbo at the very least is, so we can be pretty happy with that. Soul's gonna push some stuff back. No deal with the devil, and then we go down to Hush Fight. We've had some good runs over these past couple ones. Part of it has honestly been the wackiness of taking random stuff, and the air rune really doesn't help us in the void, does it? So we should probably just pop it here. I'm trying to think, because in the void you don't get chests. And these aren't guaranteed items, but they could potentially contain items. Wafer is unbelievably good. Absolutely what we want here. The tiers upgrade here I value quite a bit, and I also value the ability to crack this open. Okay, bunch of money. We're getting close to our damage maximum. I don't really value that much in here, so I don't think we're going to buy anything. I'd like to crack open all these chests. Obviously, Bumbo, you don't get the nickel. You do not get the nickel. Open everything. Guppy's head is good. Two-thirds of the way becoming Guppy, but unfortunately, unless we get a Joker card, not really going to be able to do that. Okay, the bombs are vastly unnecessary. And then open these up. We just get a couple pennies. At 99 cents, max damage. Only 13, really? And no battery charge in here. And no way for us to get a card. I think we should donate just a little bit. We're going to lose damage every step of the way. But, I squeezed past it because I'm so small. We're going to lose a little bit of damage as we're going here. Okay, well, I was going to say, with my luck, we don't get to donate much, very much, anytime anyway. So, okay, Hush Fight, basically, again, this tier right here, if I could just, like, get you to follow me this way. I'm hoping, like, my reflection, I could, like, pull the giant tier towards the center of the room. Bumbo is ripping this dude a new Anos, basically. Yeah, it's not moving at all. Which sucks, which means we're going to have to do with our dinky less damaging tier. I don't know why they're split. If you can help me out here. Bumbo, if you could stand, yeah, just stand right under that little lump there, and we're actually doing a ton of damage to him. Plus the wafer, plus Polaroid invincibility, basically as long as I can dodge decently well, and we have the soul, so I can be like, get back. Again, I shouldn't be like that daring, but proof of concept, basically, is that we have a pretty good chance. If we had, like, shielded tiers, and we could just stand inside this tier, how great would that be? Be pretty darn good. So yeah, this is just a fight of, basically just a war of attrition. Let these guys go at it. Let Bumbo do most of our work for us. I can throw in bombs occasionally. They'll do a little bit of damage. I should probably move my tier so it's actually on this guy. And Bumbo, you still standing under him? I'm assuming yes. I'm gonna assume yes. But basically, I'm just gonna be walking from side to side, left to right. Check my text, maybe. See what we doing. What's going on Twitter? I got 11 group chat notifications. What is this? Alright. Mark me down as a solid maybe. I would expect nothing but maybes from all of you. Oh, almost missed a nudge. There's a gif of Stanley Hudson looking upset. I'm a maybe. I'll be there. I got work. I got broads in Atlanta. I guess that's a song. Hot hand. Oh, nope. Don't use people's names because it's 2017. Oh, that's racist. Okay. That's the funniest thing I've heard in the past week. I got women in Atlanta. Thank you. Okay. Well, you know. Good things, basically. And nothing going on Twitter. Nothing going on Twitter. Oh, I've taken a hit. There are things going on Twitter. Michael Scott is a piece of garbage. You guys see that? I don't know if you guys are Office fans, but I am. Freaking Steve Carell pulled like the greatest Toby move of all time last night. Huge 180. It's the day after now, so I'm still bitter about it. I'm allowed to be bitter about it for a while. He tweeted, for all you Office fans like me, that The Office was returning to NBC. Which, you know, any sensible human being that likes The Office would then have a fudge and panic attack about their favorite show coming back on TV, and they would be very happy. Like, we're probably supposed to get hit right now, but the soul is the greatest. Yeah, and then later he said, oh, JK, typo, yeah, I meant Will and Grace. So, basically, like, human piece of garbage, but I still love him. He's still great. Love Michael. But, yeah, who would do that? What kind of sick, sadistic son of a gun does that? Apparently, Steve freaking Carell, I knew Despicable Me would go to his head. I knew it would. I called it. I could just tell by the movie, like, this is the kind of movie that turns you into a scumbag that lies about The Office coming back when it's not actually coming back. You don't deserve to play Gru. Got a little too much evil under his belt. All right. That fight's done now. And we only lost one heart, so we're still in a great spot. And I think this one is probably going to go down as a Judas win on Delirium, if we can find him. Now, we do have to get through this gigantic as heck floor. Am I forgetting something? I don't think I forgot anything. I always have to double check with myself. Be like, brain, was there something you were supposed to do? See, that's my problem. That's part of the reason I'm not doing anti-birth stuff anymore. I've been playing still a lot in the my free time, spare time, whatever you want to call it. And I keep forgetting to take the gosh dang, and like, I would probably be better about it if I was recording it, because then I would have a little bit more writing on it than just like playing my free time. But like, I keep forgetting to take the freaking knife pieces, and then the whole run is for nothing, because then there's no, like, at least in for the void, if you miss the if you miss the hush fight, you can't get in the door. It at least gives you some chances to make it up afterwards, you know? It gives you a couple chances to brownie first fight. It gives you a couple chances to, like, redeem yourself. Like, after you beat the mom fight, you get it. After you beat the mom's heart fight, you get it. After you beat the Isaac or the Satan or the blue baby or the blah, blah, blah. Oh, that's unfortunate. Honestly, the damage that we gain from that is probably worth less than the permanent Polaroid invincibility would have been, which has me a little upset. It's Mahatma got me a little upset, but we're still doing enough damage that, and with the wafer, we essentially have double our the HP that we actually have. I think we'll be just fine to survive this one. That was a little close. I see a tinted rock here. Can we maybe pick up the small rock that's been eluding us for the whole run? We cannot. Got Daddy Longlegs right here. Again, I'm not scared. I'm not afraid to quote Eminem. Of course, I think that song was about drug addiction. Okay, so we could actually... Can we get rid of both of them? We can! So now we're back down to permanent Polaroid invincibility, and someone let me know that not only does that give you cubes of meat, it also gives you damage, which is pretty nice. We now gained a little bit extra damage, too. 15 damage we're at. Just kidding, we lost some, because I used my nail, of course. Remember these basic facts about the game? It's not that hard. Basically, I'm taking the, if you're ever stuck in a labyrinth approach, which is just like... hug a wall and just continue around that wall the entire time until you reach the end, because the boss fights can only be at outlets, you know, outlet malls. That's the only place they could be. Stopwatch, I mean, it's boring, but I'll take it. It only works after you get hit now because it's been nerfed, but still, it's still kind of boring. So basically, I'm just gonna hug the right wall, and whatever, like, going in a clockwise fashion, whatever the rightmost room is, I will follow that room. Now, that may not... It should always work. I'm trying to think. It should always work. And even though we might have to explore more rooms than, like, cutting through the middle of rooms, it should eliminate the need to, like... It should eliminate the need, I think, the need for Tweed. No, it should eliminate the need to have to double explore rooms, although we are double exploring rooms now. Unless you find, like, dead ends, obviously. Pick these up, sure, why not? We're already at the full money. Already at the full money. Did I say clockwise? I definitely meant counterclockwise. But if I said counterclockwise, then I'm right. So accept that fact. Okay, and then no outlet up here. That's unfortunate. We're finding a lot of dead ends. Can't say I'm a huge fan. This floor is massive, so it's not like that's uncommon to find a bunch of other rooms before you find the... These are not the rooms you're looking for. You know what I'm saying? So it's not completely uncommon. I guess I'll use this here. Pop that. Was looking for small rocks still, but... We should save a charge for our boss fight when we inevitably find it for the Delirium fight. Just so we can have... It's not much extra damage, but, you know, any little bit counts. Let me be honest. Can I level with you guys? I don't think it's going to matter. I think we have enough that just on Bumbo's damage alone and some decent dodges, we could probably win this one. So, I wouldn't be too worried if I were you, unless you enjoy worrying. If that's just like, if it's just like your turn on for whatever reason, just get you good. I love worrying, man. I love this inability to remain calm. Then go for it. I can't judge you. Okay, there we go. Already got full money. Mom's heart fight. Okay, we're just, only problem with like not finding his, oh, that's unfortunate we took a hit there. The only problem with not finding the Delirium fight pretty quickly is that you're essentially giving him more possibilities to transform into. We did just get the spun transformation, which is pretty nice. That's some extra 1.62 damage there. Now the boss fight here, could it be Delirium? I mean, it could. Is it gonna be Delirium? I hope so. It's the Frail. So again, just giving him more annoying bosses to transform into. Fate's Reward, why not? We're not really firing, but we move our tier with Matsuya back and forth from time to time, so it'll come in handy. I'm trying to figure out, like, I'm still trying to figure out what we're gonna do after... after we finish all this stuff, like after we finish the 1001%, oh god, there's too many possibilities. I just broke my rule, I'm pretty sure, but I think we're fine. Keep going this way. Yeah, I think we'll find it eventually. Because I don't know how many times, it's kind of like, I hate to say it, but like I think the void is gonna end up just being another dark room, if that makes sense. To where once we're just doing runs for streaking purposes, it's just gonna be it lives again. I guess technically it was Mom's heart last time. Like we're probably just gonna be doing streaking runs to the chest. So probably the void will never be seen again unless we like beat the chest and decide that afterwards we want to like run in there and do some stuff. Okay, where are we at? See, now I disobeyed my own rule, and I'm a little lost. Excuse me, did something just hit me? No, it did not. Small rock? Still no small rock. Two spirit hearts. Okay, this has to be it. It has to be it. Skolex? Still not it. I swear, Curse of the Lost on this giant floor is maybe the worst place to get Curse of the Lost, just because I'm gonna get lost, if that makes sense. It should make sense. You're not dead yet? Okay, sad bombs will take. 33 sad bombs. Certainly got nothing against it. Okay, I think we've explored this option. Yes, and then we explored this option. And that connects. Okay, so another dead-end juncture, basically. Almost ran right into that. We've done that boss fight. We've done that boss fight. We have no boss fight in here, and you have no authority over me. Okay, got another set of junctions up here. Okay, take the right path, like I said. All right, just kidding. Useless. Gotta be getting close. And I think we've fought 6 or 7 bosses thus far, so whatever this next one has to be, it's gotta be... Oh, it's a cage. So we were at 6, and my ability to count is even worse than I initially thought. What are we gonna get from this? Don't want the HP just in case, and we already have the sponge transformation, so that can only make me sad. Okay, not this way. Not this way. To the this way, then. Okay, this is like seems like last junction of rooms. It also seems like the delirium fight is always in a room by itself, which I don't know if that's by design or what. So if I just like stand in this tier back here, yeah, you'll just like run into it. That's pretty cool. All right, that's not so cool. And then the rest of the fight, okay, plus stopwatch, plus we just have a lot of things on this run that just make it pretty. Even with stopwatch, this guy is not that fast. Okay, he can still teleport, which is obnoxious, but I would say I don't get why he can teleport, transform into the haunt. The little haunt, I should say. It's not a boss. It's BS. Hey, pop up. Again, just there's no issues here. I'm just going to go ahead and stand back by this tier here, and hopefully they'll come on over, take a visit. If you'd like to take a visit, I think that'd be pretty cool. I'll take a drink of tea. Like, I'll just, like, stand. There you go. Right in the kisser. Okay, go and stomp right on that. There you go. We're not doing, like, crazy damage, but it's enough to make me pretty content, and that's a pretty good spot for that to be. I can be pretty content with that. Keep that going. Excuse me, I would like to stand back in my spot, though. I don't know why there's two of them. Seems both dastardly and sinister. Ragman's gonna come at us. He got nothing. He's gonna throw his heads. You're stuck, man. Again. If you had any concerns, I could just stand here and drink my tea for the remainder of this fight. Let Bumbo do his thing, basically, and, honestly, could probably... I'm just going to try standing here. I'm never going to move again. I bet we don't take damage. I'm putting money on this, so don't prove me wrong. All right, I've been proven incorrect. But at least we can get the knife in here now and be like, hey, you want to stay on this knife? It's pretty cool. It's like a nice knife. I got it from an infomercial at 7 in the morning. Actually got an entire set. You would not believe. Oh, my God. They're actually used in Japan by actual sushi chefs. I don't know if a sushi chef is a thing, but I'm sure it is. You don't really cook it, though, so I guess you wouldn't technically classify it as a chef. Couldn't tell you, though. We're seeing this guy die a lot. Maybe we'll do a greedier mode run next time. Just to switch things up. Oh, we got a new item. What's this item? Okay. Shade has been unlocked. Okay. Just another Judas Shadow, maybe? I have no idea. But that's going to be Void Hard mode done with Judas. So how many characters we got left? Let's take a little one, which I don't want to do. 2, don't mind doing. 3, really don't want to do. 4, don't mind. 5, really don't mind. 6, don't want to do it. 7, don't mind. 8, kill me, 9, kill me, 10, kill me. We have 10 more void challenges, and then we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 greedier modes. And actually, maybe we'll do a poly next time, and we'll try to get the hush fight done. Maybe, I have no idea. We'll figure that out next time. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. If you did enjoy, make sure you subscribe to become a citizen of Playcrastination today. And if you know anybody that you think would be a great Playcrastinator, go ahead and send them on by because we'd love to have them. But with that, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys next time.